I'm Ilyen St. Hilaire, a Microsoft employee on the Forms team, and today I will do an introduction to Microsoft Forms. In an era where we're interacting increasingly with computers and we have AI and so on, it's interesting to have a product that allows you to query other people for their feedback. And so that's exactly what Microsoft Forms does, that and much more. In this video, I want to do an overview of Microsoft Forms and how to use it. And in a further video, we're going to take a look at various different topics and more expert usages. But for this video, I want to start by going on my desktop and bringing up my favorite browser, and then go to the Microsoft Forms site. So Microsoft Forms is accessible at forms.microsoft.com or forms.office.com. It doesn't matter, either way, one will work. Once you get there, you'll see this introduction page. You will have to sign in. You can try it for free and just play around with it. But the way to use it correctly is to sign in using your Microsoft account. If you don't have a Microsoft account, you can go and create one. You'll be able to click on sign in here and get your account. Now, I'm going to sign in using my account, and I'm going to be using my Hotmail address. And then I will have two-factor authentication. I really encourage everybody to use two-factor authentication. And so I have my phone here, and I will hit approve. So in this case, no password, just approve on my phone. And there we go. We are at the main Microsoft Form portal. There's a few things here to highlight. We have the new form and new quiz on the upper left. We have templates that you can use to quickly get started. You can see recent forms you've played with, either ones you've created or people have shared with you. You can click on My Forms to see just your forms, forms you've filled out, favorite forms, and so on. So I'm going to create a new form here. So I'm going to start by deleting my old one that I have right there. And there it goes, it's deleted. And now I'm going to click New Form. And just for this example, I'm going to create a form for a party I'm going to do. So I'm going to say my party questions. And already Microsoft Forms is looking at, based on what I'm typing here, different questions that I could be asking, like people's a name, phone number, and so on and so forth. But in my case, I want just to ask what day of the week would be the best day to make a party, for example. So I'm going to do multiple choice question. There's different question types you can choose. Choice, multiple choice, text, rating, date. You can also click this box and get more option here. But I'm going to say multiple choice, and I'm going to select here the question and type what day of the week would be best. And then based on this, Microsoft Form already is trying to see where I'm going here. So it's proposing different days of the week that I could choose. I'm going to click Add All. And so it's going to add all the days of the week here. And I'm done. I already have my first question. If I want to add another option or different options, I can do that in the bottom here. But another thing I want to do is I want to allow the person to respond with multiple answers. So I'm going to click the multiple answers here, and I can set how many, but I'm going to pick no limit here. And you can say require if you want. You absolutely require that people answer this question. I'm also going to ask another question. What food would be best? Oops, let's see here. Question right there. What food would be best? And then you can answer, the person can answer with a text of their own. And so here you can say long answer if you want to provide a larger text box, but I'm going to keep it small here with just a one line. And you can say required or not. So that's it. And in a few seconds here, or a minute, I've already put two questions together. I can click on style and pick a style for my party. So for example, I don't know, there he goes. I want something with flashing things in the back, or maybe this here is very interesting and there's like a little festive style to it. So I can apply the style and then be done. And that's it. I have my questions that I'm ready to send to people. Now, before I send it, I can click preview and take a look at what the quiz will look like, or the questionnaire will look like. Your invited location to the event, I can fill this up. I click start, what day of the week would be best. And by the way, if I answer here, so let's suppose I want to answer Friday and Saturday, and what food would I like? Let's suppose I like Jell-O, and I say submit, then I've already put one answer in. So I can hit back there, and I'm back to my quiz, and I already have one response. Now, let's suppose I want to share this quiz to other people. I can click collect responses, and there's a URI here that I can send by email, you know, to my friends for them to answer. I can also shorten the URI. This is just to make it more practical. So I have a smaller URI they can cut, you can cut and paste or access, and you could hit enter and access the questionnaire like this. Or there's other ways you can post the questions to people, like a QR code and so on. Okay, so now once you've sent out the questions, people can click on your link, they can answer. So let's suppose somebody here, So I'm gonna go back to collect responses. I'm gonna grab this URI and I'm going to answer my own resume, my own form another time. So I'm gonna say just Friday and I would like cake. There you go, send. Perfect. And then you can submit another time if you want. So because this is an anonymous survey for how I set it up, then people can answer multiple times. And so let's suppose these two, and I want, let's suppose I want apples as the food. You say submit, and there you go. Okay, so now I can go back to my my forms here, and I have my questions, and you can see at the bottom there's three responses. So three people have already responded to my form. I can click on it and click on responses, and I can see the responses I've gotten. So three people have selected Friday, one Thursday, one Saturday, and you can click more details if you want. You can also view individual results, which is nice. So, and in this case, it's anonymous because this is the type of form I'm doing for now. And then what food would be best, and you can see the latest responses here. And in more detail, you can take a look at each response and what they answered. So this will give you a really good idea how to organize your party. So anyway, this is this was my very quick overview of forms. Of course, we'll be drilling into a lot more details on how to do quizzes, presentation mode, sharing, collecting data, analyzing the data, all this stuff in further videos. Hopefully you liked it. Thank you very much.